Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog. And today we are going to talk about some of the marketing for the Venom movie for the Blu-ray and DVD release and the digital release, which I think has just been stellar. And a lot of people are like, hey, how did this movie make so much money? And I would credit at least some of it, or if not half of it, maybe, to the marketing team, because this movie was really marketed well. I don't know how much they spent on marketing, but their marketing was very effective. I mean, everything we talked about in China, where they did these like little, like, you know, drawings of like how Venom would make a great boyfriend, and they were trying to market that to like younger girls so that they would go see the movie and bring their boyfriends to the movies. It was really funny, and that clearly that worked maybe on some level, because that movie made, you know, almost $300 million just in China alone, which is crazy. And I know Aquaman's doing really well right now, which I'm very happy for, and I'm going to go see it actually today. But I am actually a little bit glad, because I'm like, it's doing good, but it's not doing Venom good. and so I'm like, all right, opening weekend, 70 million. That's cool, because Venom did 80 million. And opening weekend in China, it was like 95 million. But that's cool, because Venom did 111 million. So this movie is rocking. And the Aquaman movie has great marketing too. And I think that's why it's doing so well. And this isn't me trying to like crap on DC or anything. I am excited to see Aquaman, considering I don't really care about the character ever in the comic books that much. I just liked him on the Justice League cartoon and the Justice League Unlimited, but so I'm excited to go see Aquaman later. But for Venom, though, you know, the marketing has been stellar, has been really, really great. And they ramped it up even more with the digital and Blu-ray and DVD releases, which is fantastic. It's just so awesome that they're taking it to this level and having so much fun with it. I think they're kind of taking a page from the Deadpool book, which is, hey, if people make fun of you, kind of lean into the humor and just kind of go with it. And so if they meme you, you know, just meme back in a way, you know, and just have fun with it, be light about it, and just don't take yourself too seriously. And I think that's what's so great about this. I think a lot of movies are like, dun, 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 fate of the world, dun, 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 you know, everything's going to end. And that's kind of where we are, especially the Marvel movies. It's all doom and gloom, even though the movies have a ton of jokes in them and everything, but their marketing is more like, this is it. It's the most epic thing. You got to see it. You got to see it. And Venom was kind of more like, hey, you know, if you have a little bad side to you, if you have a little evil streak, you should come check this out. It's a fun little movie. And I think people just appreciated that. It was a nice breath of fresh air departure from every other one, you know, every other style of comic book movie that's out there right now. And I know a lot of people didn't like the movie overall, but there were a lot of people that really did and just had fun with it and just learned because of the marketing. They just eased into it and was like, all right, this doesn't look like it's taking itself too seriously. Let's just have fun and have a good time. And so they're continuing that. Sony is doing that, and I love it. If someone out there from Sony marketing is watching this, which, you know, I doubt, but if someone is, please let me interview you, because you guys are killing it. I love the stuff you did. The first thing I saw was this little clip here that you're going to see. You'll see videos pop up where it's basically from the movie Love Actually, but it's like the Venom version. In that movie, there was a guy who was hitting on, I think, Keira Knightley, but she's like, I don't know what was going on there. Like, he didn't want to say anything because I think her boyfriend was in the other room, so it's kind of a little creepy in a way. So he was like hitting on this girl, but pretending it was, he's like, say it's Carolers. And he's like pulling these signs and he's like, I really love you, you know, like, but I'm glad you're happy with this other guy who's my friend and everything. And you're just like, I don't know. It's a weird scene. But they kind of mock it here with the Venom stuff, which I really dug that they did that. And then there was, something else I saw, which was this to market the Walmart exclusive, which is the action figure. And they released this little cool, like, 30-second cartoon commercial of these kids playing with toys, and then Venom coming in and destroying everything. And then the dad's like, hey, kids, time to, you know, to do your homework, whatever. And he's like, Dad, we can do whatever we want, you know. So it's just like this cool little, like, late 80s, early 90s kind of cartoon that they cut together. And I really liked that. They embraced that. They were like, hey, Venom's like a, you know, character of the late 80s, early 90s. Let's kind of have some fun with that marketing. This one is really, really awesome. They did Street Fighter, which is, there was these scenes in Street Fighter 2, in between matches where you had to like test your endurance and you would beat up cars. So they did this like really great, like 8-bit, you know, Venom tearing up this SUV, which is really cool. This is kind of a deleted scene, a nod to the deleted scene in the movie where the alarm's going off and it kind of enrages the symbiote, and then Venom like destroys it. That's one of the deleted scenes, and we'll talk about those in another video. But I just thought that was really great that they did like a Street Fighter reference on top of everything. Then they did these cool like animatics with where they did like pop art and it looked comic booky, and they had like images from the movie, and then they had like, you know, text over it like a comic book, and made this comic book collage. I thought that was really great with moving images. That was really cool. That was something we saw at the Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse premiere. They had like a little room where you're surrounded by comic book panels that you can like manipulate and interact with and watch. So it was cool to see them kind of do that here in this way. Then also promoting whenever it did do something really well, this is great. What marketing should always do is lean into the good as well. So for the fact that the movie was number one on iTunes is huge. You know, so they did a little snippet and put on Instagram and Twitter, I think in their Facebook page too, of them accomplishing that it was the number one movie on iTunes. And I think even this year in 2018, Google searches for action movies, Venom was one of the top trending movies throughout the whole year. So again, like whether you loved or hated this movie, the marketing on it was super, super effective. And that's great. And that's, you know, helps get this a movie like this of this caliber up to the $850 million marker, which is at 854 right now. And like I said, I think it's going to start to die out now. It may hit 860, but I think that's probably going to be the peak of it. But man, is that a ton of money, especially for a movie that cost $100 million to make. So yeah, this marketing team is just genius. So we have that. We had the Google search thing. Then they did this, like, naughty and nice, and they've done a couple of these, but my favorite one was the one where they actually show She-Venom, and it was like Eddie Brock kissing Anne Wang, and it's like, ooh, nice. And it's like, this Christmas, be nice. And then it was like She-Venom kissing Eddie, and then it's like, or be naughty. It's like they're really leaning into, like, a lot of people got really uncomfortable and grossed out by that. They memed it a ton with, you know, like Eddie getting kissed by She-Venom, and they were saying like, oh, it's the symbiote kissing him and stuff. It's like, well, the symbiote's kind of asexual. It reproduces asexually, and even though it has like the dark, grim voice of a guy, that also is basically coming from Eddie. It's bringing his id to life. It's giving his id a voice in a way. And that's, so it's not really, probably doesn't really sound that like that when it's separated from him, even though it is separated from him at a point in the movie where it's talking to him, but it's still kind of attached to him on his shoulder, and it comes out and talks to him. So I don't know. It'd be really interesting to see if in the second movie, if it actually fully detaches and it sounds like something else. Cause remember when it was Anne in She-Venom scene, it sounded feminine. It, you know, took Anne's voice, her id, in the back of her head, and it brought it out and made like an Anne Venom voice. So to me, it's like, you know, I don't know. I guess you have to read a little bit into it. So it wasn't too weird to me. But because people memed it and they're like, oh, there's like a weird relationship, a love triangle here between the symbiote and Eddie and Anne and whatever. You know, the movie just kind of leans into it. The marketing leaned into it with this promo, which I thought was pretty funny. Because I don't think other movies would have had the guts to do something like that. Except maybe Deadpool. And I think they kind of pulled from that Deadpool page of like, hey, look, just have fun with the marketing, and you know, hopefully everything will go, you know, that, you know, go well for us. And it seems to have done so, especially with the amount of money the movie has made, and especially now what it's making on Blu-ray and DVD. The sales are, from what I hear, are doing really well, but we won't know numbers on that. At least I don't think we will until a little while. So I'll do an update like maybe in January or something after Christmas, and we'll see how the December sales of the Blu-ray and DVD and digital went. I'll look that information up and bring that to you guys as soon as possible. They've done a lot of great stuff. The one thing I love is they did this video here. This went up today, which is like a little fireplace, and it has Peter, Miles, and Cletus, and it has Venom putting a copy of the Venom Blu-ray in each of their stockings, and then he's also putting lungs, pancreas, and liver or whatever, and like all in their bags or their heart or whatever. It's really funny. That was really cool. But then what they really did that really blew me away, and I actually had this playing last night when I fell asleep, which was like, I think it's like 10 hours of Venom just sitting in front of a fireplace, and you just hear the fireplace crackle. I love this because that's something that happens a lot, especially at the Christmas time, where people upload these YouTube videos, or companies will upload these videos, or even on TV, you know, a channel might, you know, post this up at like midnight or something, and they'll just have a couple hours of a fireplace, you know, burning, and you just hear the sounds. It's nice and relaxing, you know, especially for people like me who don't have fireplaces. So it's just nice to like have that sound in the background and stuff. So they did that with Venom, and they have Venom just sitting there for 10 hours in this little flash animation, and you just hear the fire going, and he's just sitting there sipping on like hot cocoa or something. I'm assuming it's hot cocoa because he likes chocolate. So someone was like, oh, it could be coffee. I'm like, I'm thinking it's hot cocoa. But yeah, it's pretty funny stuff. So just seeing them have this much fun, just seeing them go to this level is really awesome for a fan like me, because I really enjoyed the movie. Like I said, I think someone commented like, hey, I wish you enjoyed the movie more because I really liked it. I gave it a 10 out of 10. It's like, yeah, I still got to, you know, review things the way I review things. Everyone's going to be different. What I don't like in a movie, you may not, you know, you may like, and vice versa. So for me, the movie was a 7 out of 10, but it was a really fun 7 out of 10. And I really liked the movie, and I own it on Blu-ray, which is saying a lot because I don't really buy a lot of movies anymore, or even go see the movies in theaters. And I saw this movie three times times in 1 week and then a fourth time a couple weeks later. And I might go see it one more time before it leaves the theater this week since I have a couple days off. So yeah, I might see it one more time. Even though I own it on Blu-ray, I kind of want to get that movie experience one more time with it. And I figure the theaters will be dead, so I won't have to deal with crowds and stuff when as far as like sitting in the theater goes. But yeah, this is awesome. So I want to hear, what do you guys think of the marketing? And if anyone out there in Sony marketing would like to be interviewed, if you're allowed to be, I would love to have you on the show and talk about this stuff because I think this stuff has been really fun to witness and share on social media, especially on Twitter and Instagram. It's been really cool, and seeing other people share it has been awesome. So you guys are doing great. Keep up the good work. I hope you guys get rehired to do the second movie, and I hope you do really cool stuff with marketing for Carnage. I can't wait to see what you guys come up with there. Thank you so much for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Happy holidays, and I'll come back probably on Christmas Day with one more Venom vlog, and we'll give out a bunch of digital codes, and then we might take a couple days off so I can get back into work, and then in the new year, we'll come back really strong. So I won't try to take off too much time, but I do need some rest because of some health things that have been going on lately. But today I felt really good, and I wanted to share this with you guys, so I'm glad I could. So thank you again, and I will see you soon. Peace.